say whole mass of where the whole mass is present, where the whole mass of the atom is present, the whole mass of the atom is present in inside the nucleus only. That is what we have been said. So the mass of atomic mass of an nucleus, sorry, atomic mass of an atom means what we can say? Mass of nucleus. Is it yes or no, guys? Because that is only number of protons plus number of neutrons are present. Yes, Al Mukil? Yes?
Sir.
That is what we can say. So, if because of, yes, please ask me. So, because of its hard and as well as dense, we can say whole mass of an atom is centered at its nucleus. That is what the point you can say. So, because of its dense and hardness, so the whole mass of an atom is located at the center at its nucleus. So we can say the number of alpha particles which are deflected is very, 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 very small. So we can conclude that the size of the nucleus is what, guys? Very small or very large? It will be very small as compared to the size of an atom. Do you understand, everybody? And it has been found that experimentally, basically, if you take any atom, the radius of nucleus, it has been found that 10 power 5 times smaller than the radius of atom. That is the most important thing which you have to remember. So if you'll consider, this is what the atom of an radius of an any atom, then the nucleus is present how many times, guys? It is 10 power 5 times smaller than, do you understand, not larger, smaller than the radius of atom. That is what you have to understand, everyone. Are you understand, Ra? Please respond. Laksha? Aswita, so that is what the thing which we people can conclude.
Understood, sir.
Yes. So the radius, the nucleus which is present inside the atom, because of its hardness and dense, the whole mass is located on this nucleus only, and its size is, experimentally it has been proved that 10 power 5 times smaller than the radius of atom. That is the most important thing we have to understand. For example, if you imagine a very large stadium, then large stadium, if you keep a small peanut, is it possible to see that? Suppose this is the stadium. Okay. Imagine. Yes, so, our nucleus also same situation. If you imagine the complete stadium, understanding, complete stadium is considered as what? Atom. Then if you place a small peanut or nut in at the middle or somewhere in the stadium, then that is what we used to call it as. It is equals to what? A size of nucleus. Is it okay, guys? Comparison, I'm saying. So what is the size of the nucleus? It is 10 power 5 times smaller than the radius of the atom. Is it okay, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That is what you have to remember. So, this is what the Rutherford made his observations, and from this we can say Rutherford alpha particle scattering experiment shows that the nucleus is present in the atom. Is it yes or no, guys? Yes. So the nucleus means center is present in the atom, and we can say the important information about this nucleus. What is the important information you made nucleus? Anybody can say? A nucleus of the atom is positively charged. That is why it is showing the deviation. Yes or no, Jayavarshini?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And the second point, nucleus of an atom is very dense and hard. That is why repulsion of alpha particle is taking place. Very few. And very few repulsion and deviation is taking place. That is why we can say, because of that, the nucleus is what? 10 power 5 times smaller than the size of the atom. That is what we can say. A nucleus of an atom is very small as compared to the size of the atom as whole. These are the observations we can make from Rutherford alpha particle scattering experiment. What is the name of this experiment, guys? Rutherford's alpha particle scattering experiment. So right, third point, everybody. Third point is very important point, and with this we'll end it also. Write it. The observation that, what is observation? Third observation, Monish, Pradosh, this is what the third observation you can see here. What is this?
Very few particles reflected back.
Bouncing back, or we can say turning back, right?
Turning back.
Yeah. The observation that a very few alpha particles Yes, right. The observation that a very few alpha particles completely rebound on hitting the gold foil shows that the nucleus is very dense and hard. Nucleus is very dense and hard, which does not allow the alpha particle.
Sir, nucleus is very dense and hard.
Very dense and hard, which does not allow the alpha particles to pass through it. Hitting the gold foil shows that the nucleus is very dense. The nucleus is what is, guys? Very dense and hard, which does not allow the alpha particles. Which does not allow the alpha particles to pass through it. Does not allow the alpha particles to pass through it. Do you understand, everyone? Yes or no? That is.
Yes, sir.
So that is what you people need to remember. So now, what is the observations we have been made from this regarding nucleus? 3 points we have been made. Please keep reading. Conclusions made. This is not Rutherford conclusions, only regarding nucleus. Do you understand, guys? Not I am saying the conclusions made by Rutherford experiment. Understanding? Only conclusions made for what purpose? Only for this third point. That is what? The nucleus. Understand? Write it. Conclusions made by Rutherford's alpha particle. Rutherford's alpha particle scattering experiment. For nucleus is. So first point, what is? We can conclude that nucleus is present. Yes or no? Elvokil, Prados, Tamil Selvan. So from first point, which we have to observe is, we can conclude from this, every atom contains nucleus. Now, what is the nucleus characteristics from this? We can say very few are bouncing back, very few are showing deflection. So that the first point we can write down, nucleus of an atom. What is the charge, guys? Nucleus of an atom is positively charged. That is the first point. Nucleus of an atom is positively charged. First point. Please, all of you write. First observation made it is. What is the first observation? Nucleus of an atom is positively charged. Nucleus of an atom is positively charged.
Nucleus of an atom is positively charged.
Second point. What is the second point? Nucleus of an atom is. See, somebody is bouncing back by hitting us. Means in the sense of what? They are very strong. We are very hard. That is what we can say. Denser and hard. That is what nucleus also. So nucleus of an atom is very dense and hard. Nucleus of an atom is very dense and hard. Nucleus of an atom is very dense and hard. Is it okay, guys? Nucleus of an atom is very dense and hard. Next, third point. Nucleus of an atom is very small. Nucleus of an atom is very small. Shruti, are you understanding, Shruti? Nucleus of an atom is very small. As compared to the size of the atom, nucleus of an atom is very small. As compared to the size of the atom as a whole. And it is how many times smaller, guys? The radius of a nucleus, it has been found how many times?
10 to the power 5.
Yes. So you can write that point. So the radius of nucleus is.
Sir, can you repeat once, sir?
Yes, you can write. At that point you want, you can write the point. The nucleus of an atom is very small as compared to the size of the atom as a whole. That's all you ever seen. Understand? As a whole. Now down,
yes, sir.
The radius of nucleus is 10.5 times smaller or bigger? Shakti?
Smaller.
10.5 times. 10.5 times smaller than radius of atom. That is what you have to remember. Clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
What you have to remember. NUCLUUS. Okay, Sai. So this is what observations made by Rutherford. So in exam, they will ask you, draw the Rutherford's gold foil scattering experiment and write his observations. You have to write these points. So now after that, in tomorrow, we'll study what is nucleus, and later we'll study what is the Rutherford model of the atoms. Means what is the things he has been concluded, that everything we will write it, and what is the drawbacks of Rutherford model of atom. So this also is having some drawbacks, that with the drawbacks only, then another scientist called as Niels Bohr explains the stability of an atom. That is what the third atomic model, that is what we can say Bohr's model of the atom. So that is all we will study in the next class. So after that only, this chapter having atomic number, atomic mass, and isotopes and isobars and all. That is all very simple concept we will study in the tomorrow's class. So after this, I will end today's class. Then you can relax. Thank you, everybody. Bye. We'll meet tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.